please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Mr. Krishna Kumar, any other areas where you think prices are still reasonable and there is certainty of growth as you look ahead into the next couple of quarters, maybe even next year?
I think, you know, wherever you have quite a strong visibility of growth and confidence in the profitability and margins, like, for example, the FMCG space, the food space at this point in time, you are seeing these companies, you know, which are quite richly valued. So that is definitely, you know, a premium to visibility and good free cash flows, which the market is willing to pay in this current phase. Having said that, I think, you know, there is definitely a lot of growth that will come through in the financials. Basically, you are seeing that there is a lot of constraint on the PSU banking space in terms of the ability to lend. Basically, that's putting a lot of pressure on the system. So the credit growth is basically moving away from the PSU space and into the retail banks, the private sector banks, and the NBFCs, which are kind of stepping up to fill the void. So there is a lot of you know, growth happening on the private banking space in terms of growth, and we do feel that many of these companies would be able to continue on a 30 to 40% kind of growth over the next couple of years, which really is something that we could bet on, basically. Mm-hmm.
Just coming back to this whole oil conundrum that we're facing, Mr. Krishna Kumar, what is your sense in terms of how investors should probably approach the entire oil and gas space? Because there is fear that ONGC might again face the brunt of these higher oil prices and you know, partake in the subsidy sharing, etc. In that context, what would you recommend?
So I think the play would be a lot more on the oil marketing companies in the oil space. So I think these are the companies which have been impacted quite badly over the last 6 months, with crude going up, and you know, because of some of the elections which came through, the price hikes weren't coming through. So there is a build-up in terms of concerns about how the profitability of these companies would be impacted and the government's interference, if any, on the subsidy sharing mechanism. We do believe that you know, post elections, the OMCs have been able to take you know, continuous price increases and thereby getting to improved margins from where they were. So I think given the kind of sharp correction there and the valuations that are there, we could see some positive trade on the oil marketing companies at this point in time. I would probably also extend this whole you know, argument into looking at some of these gas companies which have also had a sharp correction, you know, in terms of either LNG terminal companies or city gas companies. I think we have seen a lot of correction there. These are companies which have very, very steady growth models and have a huge long-term growth runway in India. So these would become very attractive at current levels. Mm-hmm.
Okay, just to clarify that point, you're saying that you would look at adding on to positions in the oil sector? I mean, gas, of course, I got, but you're saying oil marketing and upstream as well?
Not the upstream, the oil, downstream companies, okay. Oil marketing companies, something which is definitely looking good. And some of them have had expansion in capacities also, which will kick in and add to the kind of delta that you see in the next couple of quarters and more.
Okay, fair enough. You know, there is this prevailing wisdom that this year and maybe even next year, all the way into the general elections, stick with large caps, stick with large businesses, known franchises, don't be too adventurous, mid caps, small caps, stay away. They've had such big runs last 2 years. Do you agree with that broad assessment? I know it's using a big brush to paint the entire space, but where do you stand on that?
I think, you know, the last quarter, the 3 to 4 months has been pretty much of a roller coaster ride with, you know, perceived weakening of the macros for India. and emerging markets in general, given the significant dollar strength that played out and also the impact of crude on several economies like ours. This coupled with the fact that, this period also saw the mutual fund houses rationalizing the schemes into the respective categories as per SEBI norms, we have seen a fair bit of, realignment of portfolios of large cap diversified equity funds, wherein they had a fair bit of mid and small cap exposure. So that incremental, selling that also came through basically in this period of negative sentiment has pulled down a lot of the valuations in the mid and small cap space, which make them pretty much attractive at this point in time. Given that they are growing at about 20% plus kind of average on a quarter-on-quarter basis, I think these companies definitely look interesting from a portfolio perspective. So I wouldn't be a party to the argument that one should be looking for safety in large companies only and sticking to them over the next 1 year. Needless to say, cursory look through the top 100 companies also, we have seen that there are companies which have fallen more than 10-15% in the last 3 to 4 months when the Nifty was up about 5%, right? So you had 7 companies which have corrected a lot, you had some banks which have lost probably 30% of market cap and more. So I think it's basically horses for courses. And we would like to pick good quality companies which have inherently strong balance sheets, good managements and good business models, which will be able to sustain and have good growth opportunities across that next couple of years. So I think that would be the approach which will help investors to reduce the volatility on the downside and capture the upside as it opens up. So I think a portfolio of good quality companies, irrespective of the market cap criteria, is what I would advise.
Okay. All right, Mr. Krishna Kumar, we're going to leave it on that note. Thank you very much for joining in.